Hey there, draft fans. It is LB3 back again with another draft profile video. In our last video, we took a look at Baylor wide receiver Denzel Mims. So to keep the wide receiver train rolling, in this video, we'll be taking a look at Arizona State wide receiver Brandon Ayuk. Both players are wide receivers that could have a case made for them anywhere between wide receivers, 4 and wide receiver 10. So as a Bengals fan, I'm going to make a video for both, as either could be the pick at 33 for my favorite team. So let's take a look and see how the two players compare and where Brandon Ayuk should go in the 2020 NFL Draft. To get started with Ayuk, we'll be taking a look at his athletic profile using Player Profiler. If you have any questions about some of their stuff, I explained it in Denzel Mims' video, so go check it out. Looking at Ayuk specifically, though, we can start off looking at his college dominator in yards per reception rankings, which he was very good in. Moving on to his breakout age, though, he is subpar, but he also played in JUCO before transferring to Arizona State and being behind first-round pick N'Keal Harry. So the breakout age, while not being ideal, is still understandable in his specific situation. His 40 hit the threshold, and 4.5 is about what he looks like on tape. Able to run past guys at times, but not a straight-up burner. His burst score makes a lot of sense because he can cut very quickly and effortlessly, and is able to get up to his top speed very quickly. We don't have agility drills, but they likely would have been very good considering his fluid play style. Overall, it's a good athletic profile with no glaring concerns that matches up with a wide receiver with the potential to go in round one. Now moving on from Ayuk's athletic profile, let's take a look at some of the film to see some of his strengths and weaknesses as a wide receiver. To start off as usual, we go with his strengths. We'll start with one of the simplest ones and one that ties in with a future strength or two, looking at his added value in the return game. He was a returner for 2 years, and while he only had one touchdown in 2018, he had good average return yardage on both punts and kicks. I have one clip, a punt return, it really shows how elusive and hard to bring down he can be. What he also likes is how he doesn't spend too much time dancing, but is still able to make people miss and create yardage. You can tell how smooth he's able to get side to side without having to slow down much at all. Moving on from his strength in the return game, we'll talk about how he has flashes in one of the finer aspects of route running, which is how he uses his head to fool defenders and his feet as well. If you notice, I mentioned flashes, because like a lot of the technical aspects of his game, it needs some work and to be more consistent. But overall, it's something that I enjoyed and something that suggested that he can continue to improve as a route runner. Having a good foundation of skills to build off of, or just become more consistent in, is a much better starting point than having nothing at all. Moving on to the clips, I have three of them, but they all have similar things to take away from them. In all of them, he keeps the defender locked in with his eyes and moves his feet in a way that don't give him a way of which way he's going to go. Before at the last second able to make his cut and get wide open for the catches and easy completions for the quarterback. The next two strengths that we are taking a look at both tie in with his returning ability. The first one is his ability to get into and out of cuts without losing any speed or much at all. This both helps him easily evade tacklers and also is a big help in his route running as he's able to make cuts without losing any speed, which makes it very tough for cornerbacks to stick with him if they're not being physical and keeping a hand on him. In the two clips that we have here, just keep an eye on how he is able to easily turn and keep moving without slowing down at all. This kind of thing is why I think he would have been very good at the agility drills at the combine, and I'm very sad that we did not get to see him do them. The final strength, and the other one I mentioned in regards to his return ability, is simple. It is his overall yards after catch ability. I don't think it would be hyperbole to say that Ayuk was one of the best yards after catch receivers in all of college football last season. With that in mind, it does bring to mind the question of if he is too reliant on it in the college, then in the pros, where there's better athletes and tacklers, is that going to be a concern? However, he is so good at it that I don't see a way that it won't at least somewhat transfer to the pros, along with his other skills. I've already included plenty of clips that show his ability, but here is one more clip where his decisiveness and strength helps gain extra yards. Now with that out of the way, I'm finished with the strengths, we can move on to the weaknesses, and I'm sad to say that I couldn't find a clip that really exemplified the first weakness exactly how I wanted. However, I believe it is something that litters his tape in small ways overall, and is something he will really need to work on. First weakness I'm talking about is his overall technical refinement. He needs to work on his cuts in and out of routes, especially in more complex routes, his hand usage on the field, his release, his attacking of the ball of the air. Obviously, these are all very different things, but I think they could be lumped together. It's just overall technical refinement. It's a lot of small things that could really add up into making him a better player. It is something that he could gain over time, though, as he works mostly on the simpler things and wins where he already won in college while he continues to work on that stuff to incorporate into his game in the pros. Moving on to the final weakness, Ayuk just seems to be more physical as a wide receiver. And this also ties a bit to the technical aspects of the game a little bit. Obviously, he's physical when he has the ball in his hands and fights for extra yards, but otherwise it needs work. He can be shut down by physical press corners, especially ones that maintain that physicality throughout the routes. He needs to be more physical fighting back to the ball. He needs to work on his technique dodging the opponent's press. He needs to be overall more physical throughout the route using his body and arms to build space to run routes and get to the ball. The clip that I have for this is an example where I really wish he would have done more to fight through the contact to get after the ball instead of just trying to allow it to come to him. He could have worked his way back to the ball, and even if he couldn't get back to it, it would have been more likely to draw a penalty from the cornerback. Now we are done with strengths and weaknesses. This year, as I mentioned in the last video, I am not doing a comparison, so let's just move on to my overall final thoughts on Brandon Ayuk and where I think he should go in the draft. Now obviously, Ayuk is not a perfect prospect, as no one is, and I think he should not be drafted necessarily to be the edge of an offense right away. However, despite the concerns that I have, the good is good enough that I still think he's worth a late teens to late 20s pick in the first round. His suddenness and ability after the catch is rare, and he has room to grow and a solid foundation that suggests he can continue to grow and potentially become a number wide receiver in the NFL. I recently made a video on Mims, and I'm sure some are wondering how I rate the two against each other. In the end, I came out liking Ayuk a bit better. Despite the fact that Ayuk tested worse than Mims, his speed looks equivalent on the field. Ayuk looks just so much quicker and more explosive. Mims I'd be a bit more comfortable taking to contribute year one, but long term, I like Ayuk more. For everyone who listened and enjoyed, make sure to subscribe as there will be a lot more of these videos coming. If you have any questions or comments, feel free to leave a comment and I will try to respond to everyone. At the end of the last video, I mentioned a poll I made for the video I was making after this one. I have not yet started the video, but with how close the voting has been, I think it would be for the best if I went ahead and just did a video on the top three vote getters and maybe Christian Fulton as well. As the vote winner, Willie Gay will be coming up first, so keep your eyes open for that. Thank you very much. This has been LB3 Scouting, and there will be a lot more great stuff coming.